Okay, so we are here with Robotc with Vex Cortex start page. So when you open up Robotc, this is what it's going to look like the first time. We have a couple great links over here that we're going to get to. So the Robotc trainer is on the right-hand side. So just take a look first on your start page here. On the right-hand side, we have Vex Cortex video trainer using Robotc. That's where a lot of the curriculum from the company that makes Robotc, that's where their curriculum is online. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to get ready to program in Robotc. So in this case, our equipment is the Vex Cortex. So we need to do some setup inside the program. Okay, so we're going to go under Robot. And the first thing we're going to do is see right on this robot menu, we have a number of things that we need to go ahead and check. So we need to go to Vex Cortex communication mode, and we need to switch that to USB only. So in our case, we don't have any of the VexNet controllers for our class. So we're going to go ahead and do USB only. That's our first thing, USB only. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make sure the compiler target. In some cases, you might have virtual worlds installed on your computer. So in this case, we don't. So physical robot is checked. The next thing we want to do under Debugger Windows is just check what is checked. Okay, so we just want to take a look at Debugger Windows. Once we compile and download a program, we're going to want to make sure that these things are mostly all checked. We'll go through that when we need to. Finally, we need to go to the platform type. Okay, and what we're going to do here is we're going to make sure that, see how it says Vex 2.0 Cortex? That's the default. We want to go ahead and switch to Natural Language Vex Cortex. Okay, so platform type is Natural Language Vex Cortex. All right, there we go. So that's all set. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and talk about attaching the robot now. So we're all set for the time being. However, once you get your Vex Cortex attached, what we want to do, so let's pretend we've gone through the attaching the Vex Cortex. In fact, maybe you've just seen a video on it. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to manually update the firmware. So once you get your Vex Cortex attached, you think everything's set up. The thing that you want to do to check that your Vex Cortex is operating properly, the very first thing we're going to do is to manually update the firmware. Oh, I'm sorry, is to automatically update the firmware. So once you have your Vex Cortex attached, we're going to go to download firmware and then click automatically update Vex Cortex. Okay? All right. So thanks for listening. So go ahead and make those changes. So just to review, we're under Robot. We're going to go communication mode is USB only. Debugger Windows, we just want to check to make sure what is checked. Platform type is Natural Language Vex Cortex. So Natural Language Vex Cortex. And then once everything is set up, how do we check that everything's working? Well, we automatically update the Vex Cortex. Okay. So let's go ahead and we're going to give that a shot, and I'll see you on the next video.